You there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
We rode out a farewell.
The hero guy, a soldier, or
whatever the hell he was,
who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Hank, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon, set you free. The start of this living hell that is now his life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know. Because they came after me.
Raider camp.
I started
to mean sons of bitches, aren't you?
Before the feds fell.
As you said this week.
Broadcast from an unmarked van. Moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed. Trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe
the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not murders.
Move!
Grave. Why'd they bury this shit out here again? Oh, yeah, because they're assholes.
It's that drifter. Open up.
You're not looking so good.
Around more.
Okay. What now? How am I supposed to fix this piece of crap?
What do you want?
You got something to say about it?
Need fuel? Bike's probably thirsty. Good choice, man. Good choice. Oh, yeah, that's a good piece.
Wish I had a better set of tools.
Hello, Deke? I'll wrap that up for you. Cool. Need anything else?
But now, how am I supposed to fix this piece of crap?
Hey, you take good care of her. Yep, always needing fuel. Drifter life. See ya.
In this little town called Sisters outside of Farewell. I was home, sick as hell, fever. My wife at work, I just got a busy signal. Chopper fly by overhead. Nero, on a loudspeaker. They were more than in the same doors. We heard they were setting up quarantine zones.
Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, we wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have actually come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself, and last I checked, there's plenty of assholes out here trying to take what's rightfully ours.
You should look for fuel.
Fuel can. Needed this. That should be it. Doesn't look too bad.
Hey, you've been out in the shit for a while.
Hey, yeah. I'm tired.
Oh, morning seem colder to you?
Nah, it's about the same. Like Loser says, I hear a bunk calling my name. That should do it.
Oh, I'm just gonna close my eyes for a bit. I'm ready to go back at it.